What's up, guys? Adam here. Today, I'll be showing you just how to like unpack programs or tools that haven't got protection. Because I don't want to show you how to unpack tools with protection, because I don't want my tool getting unpacked. So yeah. So what you're going to do is go and download DE4. Links will be in the description. And then a tool without protection, I'm using the GTA 5 recovery tool. Let me delete this quick. So what you want to go and do is open this, put this to the side, and open this like this. Grab the tool, drag and drop it into here. So this is open with, then we want, then it'll come up with this. You want to let it load. You'll press this, and you'll get this. Then I need to open. Yep, .NET Reflector. You need to open .NET Reflector. So, just gonna open this. Gonna wait for that to load. Right, so it's opening. Right. Hurry up. Right, so .NET Reflector's open. Right, so you just want to grab the clean version, drag it in here. Wait, hold on. Close assembly. Give it a second. Is it working now? File, close assembly, that, unload. Right, so you open it and it have nothing in it. So you want to grab the recovery tool cleaned. So you just want to drag and drop it into there. So you'll get this Windows thing. So you just wanna right click and kick and click. Actually no, first you wanna make a folder. Just call it. No, just call it code, call it visa. So I'll remember that. We'll go back into the .NET Reflector, left click, export source code, browse. Desktop, then code, then click OK, then click start. You'll also need Visual Studios. I'll leave a link for that below as well. So right, it's done. So we can close that. Close out of here. So the source code is now in here. Just open it. And you want to left click this. Open with Visual Studios. So just let it load. It takes a while. Also, as we're talking about tools, my tool, I've just done a new update on it. It's got a GTA 5 recovery shit. It's got stuff like that. It's got what else has it got? Yeah, I put advanced warfare stuff in, like exosuits where you can put your change them. Stats, a lot of host stuff, a lot of non-host stuff. Yeah. So it seems to be loading up now. takes a long while to load. Oh, it's taking its time. Jesus. If you want to add me on Skype to get my tool, see, I'm the owner of Project Yeti. Just loading my profile. That is my name. Right there, where it says account. Click that. That add that name right there. So yeah. That's what you got to do. Just add that, then tell me if you want to buy. It always says that it's still working and it just fixes itself when it's loading. Here you go, I think, yep, it's loaded. So, right, just let it load a little bit more. It's nearly done. Hold me close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Oh wait, I think it's done. Yeah. No, I don't wanna waste what's left. And oh yeah, nearly. Oh wait, now no, it's done, right. So you can drag that down there. Through the wastelands, through the and then highways, open this back up. Actually, let's minimize that this. Open this back up, yeah. So you see these two DLLs, .dll files. Just put them on your desktop. Like that. Actually, no, don't do that. Just copy them, so you still have them in there. Like that. Then open this. I'm gonna go to... wait until it loads up again. You wanna go to project? Oh, okay. So yeah, you wanna go to project. It's being really slow. Project. Add reference. Wait for it to load. Right. So you wanna click browse. Because you won't already have them, and then you'll click tab, click tab, and then click these two. Oh wait, not tab. You just want to click control and then click them two, and then click add. So they'll be on here, right there. They'll be selected. Then you want to click OK. Right now. Just loading the DLLs in, you just want to double click on Windows Form Application 4, then you want to double click on Form 1.cs. Wait for the file to load. Most people don't show you how to fix this. I'm going to show you how to fix it. So you want to click this where it says 1. And Windows Form to GS.line 111. So you just want to put two of these there. Right, so it goes green. And you want to come back. Let it load again. And now, you see the line 1. The line 1191 is gone. The error there is gone. So you want to click this one now. Do the same thing. That. I'm gonna go back, wait for it to load, then click this one, double click that, then go back into here. Then there you go, you've got it. If I was you, I would get rid of this picture box right here, or just hide it. I normally get rid of it.
left.
So yeah, then you've got the code, the source code for it, so you just like double click on one thing that you want, bang, all there. So, if you like this video, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. Alright, see ya.